The Indian Defense Minister, Nirmala Sitharaman, made a very important announcement recently. According to the announcement, India's INS Arihant nuclear submarine is now equipped with B-05 or K-15 Submarine Launched Strategic Missile, SLBM. The missile is fully operational and is capable of hitting targets with nuclear warheads at a range of 650 kilometers to 750 kilometers. This propels India to the list of select countries which have this capability. This list includes USA, Russia, China, France, UK, and probably Israel. But this is just the beginning, and India is working on K4 SLBM. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why not the Agni 5 but upcoming K4 SLBM is India's most powerful weapon against China. Let's get into the details. A nuclear triad is the capability to launch nukes from land, air, and sea, and consists of land-launched nuclear missiles, strategic aircraft with nuclear bombs, or missiles and nuclear missile-armed submarines. Each of these three platforms has their own advantages and disadvantages, but nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines are most survival part of a nuclear triad. Strategic bombers can be taken out in the air or with a preemptive strike. Any ICBM, be it American Minuteman III, Russian Sarmat, or Indian Agni 5, are all vulnerable to a preemptive strike as the launch site can be targeted. Nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines, being nuclear-powered, can loiter in the vast oceans for a practically unlimited number of days, making them almost impossible to detect using satellites or recon aircraft. So the enemy cannot take them out with a preemptive strike. This is especially significant as India has no first use of nuclear weapons policy. Only a few nations possess nuclear-powered ballistic missile submarines, since developing these are very complex and cost-intensive exercise. The INS Arihant was the first ballistic missile submarine to be completed under India's Advanced Technology Vessel ATV project. The next three ships under this project will be larger to accommodate more weapons than INS Arihant. The INS Arigat, the second ballistic missile submarine, is currently under construction and close to completion. INS Arihant is capable of carrying 12 K-15 or 4 K-4 missiles, and INS Arigat will be able to carry 24 K-15 or 8 K-4 missiles. The K-series missiles are named after Indian scientist and former Indian president Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Viewers may note that he's called the Missile Man of India, having made major contributions in India's missile programs. K-4 is a nuclear-capable, intermediate-range submarine-launched ballistic missile, under development by Defense Research and Development Organization of India. It is currently in the testing phase and is expected to be operational by 2020. K-4 has a much longer range of 3,500 kilometers. It weighs 17 tons, has a length of 12 meters, and a diameter of 1.3 meters. The missile is solid-fueled and has an accuracy of 20 to 30 meters CEP. It will carry a single nuclear warhead with a yield equivalent of 200 to 250 kilotons of TNT. For comparison, Hiroshima's Little Boy bomb had a yield of 13 to 18 kilotons, whereas Nagasaki's Fat Man bomb had a yield of 20 to 22 kilotons of TNT. With K-4, India will be able to strike deep inside China when launched from the Bay of Bengal. The K-4 will greatly increase India's second strike capabilities and will act as a major deterrent against China. It's interesting to note that India is also working on K-5 and K-6 missiles that will have much longer range, be MIRV-enabled, and be deployed in a new series of ballistic missile submarines.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.